A child with von Willebrand disease, usually the most common form of this is when you just simply don't make quite enough of what a normal von Willebrand level would be. When I talk to the kids, I explain it to them that von Willebrand is kind of like your bottle of glue that sits over the platelets and it holds them together. Von Willebrand type 1 is the most common diagnosis of von Willebrand disease, and it's when your body just doesn't make quite enough. It's like your bottle of glue is running low. And when you have just a little bit of von Willebrand disease, goes a long way. So these kids, they may not have any kind of bleeding with a skin knee or a finger cut or anything like that, paper cut, that kind of thing. But they can have mucosal bleeding. Mucosal bleeding is any kind of bleeding in our mouth, our nares, our nose. For girls, menorrhagia is a big problem occasionally for girls with bleeding disorders, and especially mucosal bleeding that comes along with von Willebrand disease. Von Willebrand type 2 is when your body makes von Willebrand protein, but the type it makes is not really functional. So it's a qualitative defect versus a quantitative defect. This can be more, children with this kind of bleeding disorder have a stronger phenotype often and can have more bleeding symptoms than von Willebrand type 1, which is a more mild but yet more common bleeding disorder. Von Willebrand type 2, children can have occasional muscle bleeds. They can have quite a bit of mucosal bleeding, including very, very severe nosebleeds, sometimes oral mouth bleeds with teeth coming in or mouth injuries. Girls can have very, very heavy periods and may need more support at school, and that would be talked about with your 504 team.